Emissions. This has been a massive focus of the US government and governments all over the world for that matter for the last few decades. And more specifically, emissions output from vehicles and especially diesel engines has been under the watching eye of the EPA. As we've discussed in other videos, the EPA has nearly entirely killed the diesel internal combustion engine through really strict emission standards. And what I mean by this is that every couple of years, we get more strict standards for diesel engine manufacturers. And that has to do with particulate matter output, NOx output, and a couple of other things. And as it gets stricter and stricter and stricter, it's unlikely that the diesel internal combustion engine will continue to exist. That being said, just because the upcoming emission standards appear to be nearly impossible to meet, it can be done with the right innovation, which takes us to Sandia National Laboratories, the masterminds behind a new type of diesel injection system which can almost completely eliminate diesel engine emissions output and potentially save the diesel engine from death. This new type of diesel injector that we're looking at today is known as ducted fuel injection, or DFI for short, and as I mentioned a moment ago, it comes from Sandia National Laboratories, and more specifically, Charles Mueller, who works at Sandia's combustion research facility. And in case you didn't know, the design of the injector in any given internal combustion diesel engine has a massive impact on power, fuel efficiency, and ultimately emissions output. Because of that, we've already seen massive amounts of innovation in the industry over the last few years and decades, with diesel engines ranging from indirect injection, direct injection, common rail injection, and most recently, we've seen some engine manufacturers switching from the tried and true piezo injector back to solenoid type injectors, as innovation has massively improved both types of injectors. With ducted fuel injection though, things are completely different. In fact, the idea behind this injector doesn't even come from an injector. It's actually based on the Bunsen burner, which is something that you can find in pretty much all science classrooms across the US in both high school and college level classes. Quote, "If you unscrew the tube on a Bunsen burner and you light the gas jet, you get a tall, sooty, orange flame. Turn off the gas, screw the tube back on, and relight the burner. Now you get a nice, short, blue flame right at the end of the tube. The flame is blue because there isn't any soot," end quote. And interestingly enough, according to Charles Mueller, the current type of injectors that we see in diesel engines, so something like a piezo injector or a solenoid type injector, use about 2 to 10 times as much fuel as needed for complete combustion, which means that there is a lot of room for improvement, which is where this new injector comes into play. When you have that much excess fuel at high temperature, you tend to produce a lot of soot. Installing the ducts enables to achieve diesel combustion that forms little to no soot because local igniting mixtures contain less excess fuel. How it works is that instead of the fuel injector spraying fuel straight into an open combustion chamber, there are ducts just outside the injector openings the fuel is sprayed through. The ducts are shaped such that as the fuel is sprayed into them, air is pulled in from the back of the ducts. You can see this in this diagram that comes from Scientific American, which I'll leave linked down in the description in case you want to check out some of the nitty-gritty details of this injection system for yourself. Ultimately, this allows for a much, much improved air-fuel mixture, and as such, a much cleaner burn, which also means less excess fuel and less soot. And according to Sandia, these numbers are represented at around 50 to 100% reduction in soot output from diesel engines, depending on the engine and the situation that you're talking about, but 50 to 100% is a massive, unheard of reduction in soot output. And sure, while soot is reduced, you still have the emissions. So the way that the emissions are decreased is that because of that reduced soot output, you can massively increase something like your exhaust gas recirculation system, which will then massively decrease NOx emissions output. And the reason you can do that is because soot is the main culprit behind EGR issues. So without that, you can just massively increase EGR usage and then massively decrease emissions output. This would then also bring with it the added benefit of improving the reliability of exhaust gas recirculation systems, which historically struggle with reliability on the long term due to soot buildup in the exhaust gas coolers, the valves that control the flow of the system, and much more. With that would also come a reduced cost of operating, as the improved air-fuel mixture and cleaner combustion would lead to improved fuel efficiency. And if you follow the effects down the line, that means that any goods which have to go through the transportation system, which is basically everything in the US, would become cheaper for the end consumer. A hidden benefit to this type of injector is that it could potentially allow diesel engine manufacturers to revert some of the changes that they've made in recent years and potentially remove some parts, such as the diesel particulate filter or diesel exhaust fluid injection, or both. The result could still be a reduced output of soot and NOx emissions output, but with massive improvements to engine reliability and cost of operating by removing those reliability plaguing emissions components. So at this point, you might be wondering, cool, when are we gonna see this injector come to market? When is something like this even gonna become a reality? And the answer to that is that it's not exactly clear. In fact, a lot of the research papers that I had cited in this video are actually from 2019, and now we're up to 2022, and we're still not seeing this injector in the real world. So it's not exactly clear when or if we will see this injector actually become a thing. That being said, it shows enough promise that companies like Ford and Caterpillar are throwing a lot of money at Sandia for research development because they want this to become a thing. Because ultimately, for Ford and Caterpillar and pretty much any other diesel engine manufacturer, if they could use this injector, it would massively improve their product. And on top of that, we're now seeing other companies in the automotive space, such as Toyota, doing their own research and development and testing on this type of injector and coming to nearly the exact same conclusion, which is a massive reduction in soot output. In theory, this injector should be able to be easily retrofitted into older diesel engines, especially very cumbersome engines like power plants, ships, and trains. Heck, even something like a semi-truck with a Caterpillar, International, Detroit Diesel, Volvo, or whatever type of engine could be targets for retrofitting with this type of injector. The point is, the design of the injector isn't such that it will be limited to brand new engines, at least according to Sandia. And to be fair, the hard part of designing a new thing, hard part of bringing innovation to any market, is not going to be making it work in a simulation or even on the small scale in real life. The hard part is going to become when it comes time to scale this up and produce it on a huge scale so that a lot of engines can use it. Things such as reliability, cost, use of materials, and a lot more can become the big hurdles when it comes time to bring this new cool innovation to market. And while it's very, very promising with a lot of companies putting a lot of money into this, it's not a guarantee that it'll even become a thing or save the diesel engine by the time it's close to being dead. Because the transportation industry is very focused on reliability, it could be a very long while until we see this new injector adopted, as new technologies are very slowly adopted in transportation unless forced through government regulation, which is how we got parts like the diesel particulate filter and diesel exhaust fluid injection. And it makes sense. Why switch injectors if you don't have to? Why risk a potential decrease in reliability and ultimately a massive dip in your profits when your engine isn't working? Until this injector is proven to be as reliable or more reliable than current injection systems, it probably won't see any type of quick adoption unless there's a clear and significant upside of reduced cost of ownership and potentially the removal of reliability plaguing emission systems such as the DPF and SCR. So what do you guys think? Do you think the ducted fuel injection system, or DFI for short, will save the diesel engine? Or will it fail to be adopted in time to actually save it? Like I said at the start of the video, we have upcoming emissions regulations from the EPA in 2024 and 2027 that are really, really gonna cut down what diesel engines are able to do. And ultimately, by a time such as 2030 or 2040, emissions regulations can become so strict that no internal combustion engine can meet them, and ultimately the diesel engine will be forced out of market. That is, unless we get some massive innovations, such as this injector. So if it makes it to market in time, we could see the diesel engine go on for much longer, but if not, it could be the end of it all. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to smash the thumbs up button, drop a comment down below, get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos, follow us on Instagram and TikTok and any other social media platforms, and I'll see you guys in the next one.